Hello everyone, today in this video presentation we are going to talk about ergonomic practice. Before that, we'll look into what actually ergonomy is. Ergonomy is a Greek word where ergos means field and nomos means to manage. So ergonomy is a branch of agricultural science which deals with principle and practice of field management for the production of field crops. It talks about what a person should do starting from sowing of seed till harvesting and post-harvest management for better yield and to get a great income after the production. And we are going to talk some of the agronomic practices: land preparation, sowing or planting time, choices of crop varieties to fit the climate and soil, irrigation and drainage system, weed management and plant protection, crop rotation and intercropping, harvesting.
Kuzu Sampo, I am Dash Lamon and I will be presenting on land preparation under agronomic practices. Before raising a crop, your soil should be prepared in which you are going to grow your crop. Today, I am going to talk about 5 steps to be followed under land preparation. Number 1. Choosing the best location like sunny spot, water availability and a good drainage site. And number 2. We have tilling your land. Till your land if needed and break the soil plot. Tilling the land helps you in opening the compact soil. Number 3, we have soil testing. Soil test will give us the information about the soil pH, nutrient content and the texture of the soil. In number 4, we have selection of appropriate soil structure. Different soil have different soil requirements, so one must prepare appropriate soil for a given crop. Some of the soil amendments are compost, manure and peat mosses. Lastly, we have leveling your field. You should flatten your field and keep the soil loose. These 5 steps should be followed as per your chosen crop, and doing so will help in better management and yield at the end. Now, let's talk about weed distribution. We know that weed are ubiquitous in nature and can be easily distributed to other places. Let's look into how weeds get distributed during land preparation.
Number 1, we have 2 machineries and tools. Weed seeds get attached to the machineries and tools that we use and later it is carried to other places. Tilling your land can favor weeds which grow from creeping, for example, field pine weed. Likewise, tillage also favors weed which grows from rhizomes, for example, stinging nettle. While tilling your field, there are chances of deeply situated weed seeds to get exposed to surface and start growing. Even if zero tillage is practiced, it will favor growth of weed seeds which are already on the surface. This is all how land preparation influences weed distribution, but to put an end to this, the only way is to eliminate weeds completely, but this is nearly impossible.
Sowing and planting time. This shows that during which time the crop should get maximum yield. It is important that planting date should be adjusted so that crop gain more nutrient and ultimately better yield. High temperature and high intensity favor early emergence of leaf and faster growth. As such, the summer crop is more better compared to monsoon and winter crop. Due to low temperature, winter yield are low except in winter crop varieties. For high humidity, it favors the incidence of pests and disease to the crop. Thus, it is better to choose a proper time for planting, keeping in tune with the season and adjusting the crops.
I'm going to present on the topic choices of crops and varieties to fit the climate and soil. Well, in this particular topic, we will basically learn about the adaptation of different crops based on different climatic conditions and soil. This is mainly because different crops require different climatic conditions for better yield. And it's also very important to consider different types of soil. Different types of soils for different crops. For now, let's look into some of the crops that are best adapted to different types of climatic conditions. Because of the fact that different crops and different varieties of crops require different climatic conditions. So, for instance, cultivation of crops like sugarcane and rice are suitable in tropical climate, which is hot and warm climate condition, and in subtropical type of climate, which is cold and warm climate So in such type of climate, cultivation of crops like millet, rice, wheat and oat are suitable. Type of climate, which is very cold climate. So in such type of climate, cultivation of crops like buckwheat, wheat, barley, etc. are suitable. It is also very important to take into account the suitability of soil for cultivation of different types of crops. So like in sandy soil is suitable for cultivation of crops like maize, millet and barley, etc. And clay soil, which has the high water holding capacity, so it is very suitable for cultivation of paddy. Likewise, loamy soil, which is the ideal soil for the cultivation of crops like jute, cotton, wheat and sugarcane. With this, I would like to wind up my presentation here. So thank you very much for watching.
Effective agronomic practices are the essential components of irrigation and drainage system. Irrigation system, it is the artificial application of water for the purpose of supplying moisture essential to the plant growth. Aims of irrigation: number one, to supply the water requirement of growing crop; number two, to use the water efficiently; number three, to avoid the soil damage. There are different methods or types of irrigation system. Number one, surface irrigation. It is the most common form of irrigation throughout the world and just flooding water. Number two, sprinkle irrigation. It is the method of applying water under pressure, which is similar to rainfall. Number three, drip irrigation. It is also known as trickle irrigation, which is the most efficient system which applies water directly on the crop. Some of the importance of irrigation system, which are: the planted crop cannot grow at a healthy pace if the agricultural field does not have proper irrigation system. So mostly agricultural production and the productivity level depend on the availability of water. Therefore, eventually it means irrigation facility need proper consideration. Irrigation has also other uses in the crop production, including frost protection, suppressing weed growth in the grain field and preventing soil consolidation. Drainage system. Drainage system, it is a pattern formed by a stream, river and lake in a particular drainage basin. Aims of drainage: to prevent or reduce water lodging and to control salinity. Two methods of drainage system. Number one is surface drainage. It is the removal of excess water from the surface of land. Number two, subsurface drainage. It is the removal of excess water away from soil. Benefits of drainage system. Drainage reduces soil and nutrient loss from runoff and can also help to avoid soil erosion.
This is Tashtama and I'll be talking on the weed management and plant protection. Actually, these two are interrelated. If the weed is managed properly and controlled, the plant is being protected. Eventually, it leads to the good yield.
Why weed management? Because the major reason is because it competes with the crop. What it competes for, I'll be briefly explaining.
The principle of weed crop competitions are as follow. The first one is competition for nutrient. Weeds absorb and accumulate relatively larger amount of mineral nutrient than the plant crop does. Example, amaranthus absorbs over 3% of the nutrient in the dry matter. Second one is competition for moisture.
Weed crop competition become critical with the increase in soil moisture stress.
The actual evapotranspiration from the weedy crop field is much more than the evapotranspiration from the weed-free crop field.
Conservative use of the Chenopodium album is 550 mm as against the 479 mm for the wheat crop.
Third one is competition for light, solar energy.
Competition for light occurs during the early crop growth season if a dense wheat growth smothers the crop settings and the crop plants suffer badly due to the shading effects of the weeds. Example, cotton, potato and several vegetables and sugarcane are subjected to heavy wheat growth during the early seedlings.
Fourth one is competition for space. Crop weed competition for space is the requirement for carbon dioxide and the competition occur under extremely crowded plant community condition. More efficient utilization of the carbon dioxide by the C4 weeds may contribute to their rapid growth over the C3 type of crop.
Now, the plant protection. The basic tip to protect the plant is by increasing the competitiveness of the crop.
Some of the agronomic tips that can be used to increase the competitiveness of the crop are:
The first one is using a higher seedling rate. Second one is using a narrow row spacing. It will increase the competitiveness of the crop through quick canopy coverage and shedding of the weed. Third, providing an optimal fertility helps to produce a healthy, vigorous seedling that can compete with the weed. Fourth one is using a clean seedling, which prevents the introduction of the new weeds. And the last one, seedling a crop early allows the crop to use early spring moisture and it allows the crop to be more competitive.
I'm the last presenter and I'll be talking on two topics, that is weed management and after the harvest of the crops and the crop rotation and the intercropping. First, we have the weed management and after the harvest of the crop. The harvesting time of the grain crops, it is very important as the weed seeds, they are retained by plants and easy to remove and discard. Weed seeds, they can collect it and destroy it during or soon after harvesting of a crop. The strategy can be implemented with the Harrington seed destructor, chaff carts, narrow window burning and bale derrick. This technology, they are based on the weed seed collection during the grain crop harvest and seed destruction to avoid the replenishment of the seed bank. Crop rotation is the essential agronomic practice because its effects on soil health and reduction in weed competition, weed growth and reproduction, which greatly reduce the weed density and it lowers the weed infestation in crop fields. And as said by Kochiki and Feliza, the seed density in the rotation of the wheat sugar beet was lower than under continuous weed. So the rotation of the maize winter wheat caused 12% reduction in the seed bank compared with continuous wheat. Therefore, crops in rotation with narrow leaf crops and crops with other different agronomic practices can reduce the wheat seed bank density. According to Mollet, growing of wheat, maize and soybeans in rotation, they tend to decrease the wheat seed bank and abundance of the broadleaf wheat. And in the intercropping, the compatible crops, they are grown together to harvest net yield and economic benefits. In particular, the crops with allelopathic potential, they are intercropped with other crop plants to help reduce the wheat intensity and improve the crop productivity. As for Saudi, the intercropping of maize and cowpeas on alternate ridges help to reduce the wheat intensity by 50% as well as improve the land use efficiency. And in the other study, relay intercropping of legumes with wheat was evaluated for wheat separation in comparison with the sole wheat crop. The intercrops not only suppressed the wheat compared with the sole wheat crops, but also they reduced the wheat density, and the red clover was the most effective intercrop for suppressing the wheat. For the conclusion, the farmers, they have several preventive and cultural methods in their arsenal that they can put together to build up a good management seed, good wheat management strategies. The convenience of using one method instead of another, it depends on the local attitudes and the constraints, such as the availability of the money and the labor, access to the technical means, environmental, social, and economic features that may limit the range of feasible economic choices. However, the agronomic practices that our group explained can change the incidence and the effects of the wheat density and the wheat community competition in the long-term management, unless other effective alternate treatments are found. Thank you.